Well, we've been talking with Pat Mahomes Sr., a former baseball pitcher and the father of Chiefs QB Patrick Mahomes, exclusively all morning. Pat's confident the Chiefs will beat the Dolphins in tonight's wild card game. And this morning, he's opening up with Fox 4's Kerry Wickersham to talk a little bit about his family, and some of it may surprise you. Hey, good morning, Kerry.
Hey, good morning. So you guys have seen the Mahomes family. The Mahomes men have been very close for years and years. Pat Mahomes is with me now. And Pat, even your dad, I mean, talk a little bit about your dad and how he raised you. You're still very close to him.
Well, he's kind of the king, you know. he's the guy that got me into sports, and he's there for Patrick, he's there for Jackson, he's there for Graham and everything. He's the one that taught us all and how you're supposed to play and everything. So Pops is always good.
That's absolutely true. I know we have some video of you with him and you with Bronze passing that whole, especially with the Mahomes men, really passing that down from generation to generation. You mentioned Graham. And I first became aware of Graham, who's Patrick's half-brother, just about a year and a half or so ago. Talk to us a little bit about Graham. You recently went to one of his football games. He plays for Brown.
Yeah, he's coming up. This will be his senior year. He's at Brown University. He's a wide receiver.
All-American.
All-American. And he finally decided that he wants to be a serious football player, so we have him in the transfer portal, and hopefully he's going to choose a school here soon, and we can go on with the next chapter of that.
And that next chapter may mean he plays in the NFL with Patrick or against Patrick.
Yeah, hopefully. He's finally come to the realization that he has a chance to play in the NFL, and so he's going to try to go out and explore all the possibilities and whatever road that leads to, try to give himself a chance to play at the next level, like we all want to.
Absolutely. The family resemblance is uncanny. I'm sure you have people tell you when they see him and become aware of him, he looks just like you.
That's what they say. They say he's the one that looks the most like me. But, you know, maybe the other boys, you know, they'll disagree a little bit, but he definitely is Mahomes.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about him, his character, his drive. I know at one point he wanted to be a politician.
Yeah, he's a little bit more laid back than the others. He kind of stays away from the spotlight. You know, he just goes out and grinds and works. But a very impressive young man. You know, he's his manners are intact. His stepdad did a great job with him. His mom did a great job with him. And now I'm getting a chance to put my hands on him a little bit more, and hopefully we can get something going here.
I know your wife, Trish, and you were at one of his games, I think in November. She shot some video of a touchdown that he caught. Tell us a little bit about that video and what was happening.
Well,
there.
We were up in New York. We were at Columbia, mm-hmm. and the game actually went into overtime, and we happened to get the ball first, and he came across. The quarterback hit him, broke a tackle, and scored the game-winning touchdown. So it was kind of pretty exciting times right there.
Exciting that you guys were so close to the sideline right there, and that Trish was able to capture that moment. So
yeah, we were all invested. You know, he had it was actually the game that he had told me to come to, and so we were up in New York. You know, me being a Met and all that, and I had some friends that came over to watch the game, so it was a great time, and he did a great job.
Yeah. What does Patrick think of having a younger half-brother who's got his eyes on the prize?
Well, he's supportive. You know, he's supportive as he always is. Hopefully, in this offseason, Patrick will get a chance to throw the football to him as he runs routes. As Patrick, you know, always has his receivers come down. So we're looking forward to that. And he's looking forward. He's supporting. And hopefully, you know, his word may be a little good, too. Maybe he can get him, you know, in a door or two, too.
Absolutely. And that's the name of the game at this point, is just to get him through some open doors in college and possibly in the draft later on.
Well, yeah, no doubt. And, you know, he has to do his part. He has to work hard, keep mm-hmm. playing. He got a big year coming up. So hopefully he's able to go out and do the things he needs to do and maybe fulfill a dream that he's dreamt about for a long time. Mm-hmm.
Graham Walker, keep your eyes on him, folks. Okay, one other thing I want to talk to you about. Your perfect Super Bowl matchup would be Kansas City versus
the Dallas Cowboys.
You've been a long time Dallas fan, longer than you've been a Cowboys fan. But it was so interesting. You were telling me off camera that Patrick kind of wanted to play for the Cowboys. Tell us that story about the locker room notes and things.
Well, he grew up a Cowboys fan, and because of me, mm-hmm. you know, and he's always watched the Cowboys. And they used to play Baylor every year when he was at Texas Tech at the end of the season. And it was always at AT&T Stadium. And when he would get there, you know, Tony Romo and Jerry Jones would always leave him a note and tell him that, you know, he was going to be a future Cowboy and this and that. But the year before before he came out, they had drafted Dak in the fourth round, I think it was. And Dak came in, and Romo got hurt, and he won 13 games. So I told him he probably wasn't going to be a Cowboy anymore.
No matter how many notes they left in the locker room.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah.
Right. Well, we're sure glad he's a Kansas City Chief. And now that we can keep our – it would be so stunning to have two of your sons in the NFL. We can't wait for that day if it would happen. And I don't know, man, you're a pitcher. I don't know how you got two sons in the NFL. Maybe Bronze will play baseball.
Yeah, I'm hoping. That's my only hope now, that Bronze played baseball. You know, Jackson played basketball, so right. Maybe Bronze will play a little baseball.
Oh, somebody, you got to have a pitcher in there somewhere. I know Patrick's got your arm, but for sure we got to have a pitcher in there somewhere. Well, good luck tonight. I know it's going to be cold. You've got your heated number 15 jacket all on, and we're sure are glad to have you here this morning talking to us.
Well, it was my pleasure to be here as usual. You know, we've been doing this now for a while, and hopefully the people, you know, dress warm and take care of yourself, because we don't want to be reporting about y'all tomorrow.
That's exactly right. Dress warm, take care of yourself. And we do have to say that Pat and I have a pretty good record of doing pregame interviews and then having the Chiefs win that game. So let's hope that works.
Let's go.
Let's go. I'm Carrie Wickersham, Fox 4 News. Back to you guys.
All right. Amazing interview there this morning, exclusive with Pat Mahomes Sr. Thanks so much, Carrie. We sure appreciate all that.